Okay, so right now I'm going to walk you through a positional strategy that I've just entered, which can be used in any stock, more or less. And I'll just go over what is a cash secured strangle.
Want to meet like-minded traders and discuss option strategies, adjustments, and more? Just type in Discuss Nifty in your Telegram search box and join the friendly trader community.
Now, we've all heard of cash secured puts. You sell a put option, which is at the money or out of the money. And the intention behind it is that if it goes in the money, we will take delivery. Goes without saying, these kind of strategies should be done only in the highest of high quality companies and not in any company which is not in the Nifty 50. So let me, or generally, if you don't mind taking delivery of a company, any stock is fine, but prefer to do it in Nifty stocks. So today is the 23rd of April, expiry is on the 29th of April. These expire on the 29th April and I've taken a position. So right now I feel Reliance is in a dip and is a good buying opportunity. If I buy it right now, I can buy it for 910 rupees. So my buying price of Reliance will be 910 for 500 shares. Let's say I buy. Now, in case I take this strategy instead, here are the ways in which it will play out. I've sold the 1900 put, which means that if this is in the money, then my delivery price, the price at which I will be buying Reliance, will be 1900 minus 25, which will be 1875. So on Thursday, if this put is in the money, I will get it at 1875 if this was the only position. Now I have also sold the 2000 call for 5 rupees, let's say. So what that will do is, once again, if this is in the money, this has to be out of the money. My buying price will be cheaper once again by 5 more rupees, making my buying price 1870. So let me just go through how this works. So here is the Reliance position. This position expires in 6 days. Today is Friday. So today is Friday. So Monday will be the 26th. Okay, so let us say this opens on Monday, as is, nothing happens, Reliance opens flat, we will be making profit because obviously there are fewer days, only 3 days left for expiry at that point. And here are a few options. Let us say Reliance gaps down by a lot. We are making a loss, but since the intention is to take delivery of the shares, it doesn't make any difference. You will be buying the shares at 1870. So if you buy the shares at 1870, it goes down, you will be making a loss, but that is, you have used that as an opportunity to buy. It'll definitely make more loss if you buy today at 1910. Okay, so basically it's that if you buy at 1910, you will be making a 55 point loss. Whereas if you buy at 1870, you'll be making only a 15 point loss. So it goes without saying, fair enough. Let us say the second scenario is absolutely nothing happens. It opens flat. If it opens flat, you have an option. Since it's expiry week, do you want to either take off the profit, which is considerable, it's 2.6%, or do you want to, I mean, of course, these calculations are arbitrary. You don't know what exactly the situation will be. Do you want to take off the profit, or do you want to hold because you really want the delivery of the shares, so you don't mind. Now, let's say it gaps up, right? So it's not such a large gap, gaps up by 2%. Now, before your call side gives you a loss, because selling a call essentially makes you a bearish view beyond the center point of the strangle. So before it gives you a loss, it will give you a very good profit because you've entered the strangle at a break even on one side and now it has centered itself. So it will give you a profit. And at this point, in a cash secured strangle, you should generally exit. You should exit if your view was right, that it is at a dip and it's gone up, it's given you a 3.6% return, you can exit. The thing is, we've sold a put for 24 and a call for 5. So a put for 25 and a call for 5, let's say. In an up move, it's a bullish position until it reaches the center point where these two premiums start to balance. And at that point, you can generally exit. The only issue you'll have is if there's a drastic up move, and that's very rare in top quality names. So if you have more than a 5% gap up in a single day, and obviously you don't want to do stuff like this before events, you don't want to do a cash secured strangle before like their AGM or something. You want a more balanced strangle before their AGM or any particular event that might affect the underlying stock. So to summarize, basically, a cash secured strangle is nothing but selling a cash secured put, but also selling a call to get some additional credit, which gives you more buffer on the downside. And this is very good if your intention is to actually take delivery. A lot of people who sell naked puts and say it is cash secured put with no intention of ever actually taking delivery of those stocks. So in that case, it might work out not so well. But this is generally a good approach wherein you can get some additional buffer on the downside when you're selling a cash secured put. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this was useful to you.
Thank you for watching. Please post any questions you have in the comment section. Also, do not forget to like and share the video and subscribe to the channel. To find us on Twitter, Telegram and Facebook, use the username NiftyBN. Also, we post some of our trades to the community tab. So do not forget to check that from time to time.